Jackson Coppen.
He's been perhaps the surprise of the season, the way he's performed. Second in the Cup of China, second in the Ross Telecom Cup. Controversially, didn't compete in the Olympics. Plushenko retiring too late, so there was no chance for him. Seventh place going into the free for Maxim Kovtun. And he has three quads scheduled. Well, that should have been the first one, the quad salchow, but you can see he almost kicked himself. But he does get the quad toe. Around because it was scheduled to be the second quad sal there, but perhaps just wanted time. So maybe substitute it coming up here where he would have put the toe loop.
I think he's going to do two toes. No.
Both wrong. Triple flip, triple toe. Triple looks, triple toe. So it's dangerous to fiddle around with the programme. Triple axel. It seemed he's given up on the second quad now. Triple axel, double toe loop.
He's got a power-packed second half lined up here.
Well and truly there now. That was triple Lutz. Triple Salco combination. Well, it was a circuitous route, but somehow he's produced a really good performance. It could have been so much better. Must have been so alarming when he went to that first element. And his legs seemed to bump into each other when he was launching himself for the quad sal. Then he completely changed his routine around, but it hasn't done any harm. As you can see at the moment, he has the best technical score.
Yeah, well, I think it was a good move, to be honest with you, if you're not feeling confident with the quad, to put the Lutz toe in. The Lutz toe has a base value of 10.1. The quad toe has 10.3. So the difference, as far as points concerned, is very little. The difference as far as risk is concerned is massive.
Yes.
So I think it was a good call. And sometimes these guys will train a couple of different scenarios with the opening of the program, just in case the timing doesn't feel quite right on the quads. So from then on in, he was rock solid, though, wasn't he? What a power-packed second half of the program that was.
He is a brilliant skater, and he must have been so aggrieved. I know a lot of Russians were, about the timing of Plushenko's retirement, which meant that this brilliant talent, who had a shot at a medal, let's be honest, a real shot, wasn't given the chance to skate. It may have just been an unfortunate set of circumstances, but it certainly hurt this fella.
It did indeed. I think had he skated a little better in the European Championships, he may well have got the nod. There you can see he got the entry into that completely wrong. You've got to put a lot of pressure on that back inside edge. You can see the skate sliding away from him, got over the heel of that left foot, and there was no way back from that because you've got to push off the toe on that back inside edge. And his weight was on the wrong part of the skate, but no mistakes on the quadruple toe loop. And that shows the character of this guy, because the attempt on the Salco would have felt awful. And to come back and nail the quad toe like that, and a triple axle of this caliber, really does show that he has the character to compete right at the very top.
Yeah, two triple axles, both of them clean. And his energy levels were strong at the end. He was still piling in the content, and his technical score was going upwards and upwards.
Yeah, it really was a great, great effort.
So it looks like he's going to be the leader. It's going to be close between him and Jeremy Abbott, but he's got there. 2:47, that's a career best. Not a career best long program, but career best overall. And he goes into the